semester to you all. So, in today's video, I guess you guys know what I'm going to be doing. Testing chocolates. And, of course, rating them. A barista with my favorite color, green, and of course he had to have a girlfriend, and that happens to be. He's also a barista, and she has a pretty red outfit on. It's so cute. The stitching is really well done. Same as the padding. It's structured very well. So, too cute. Everything in this girl boss pink binder. And before we get started, we get to choose a pen. This one looks pretty enough. and tender of the Eastern chocolate. Testing. Tasty chocolate. Very sweet. Smells chocolatey. I think somebody cheapened out chocolate quality. Did not leave the best impression, but it's not the worst that I've had. Now, if you want to see a full review on any of these chocolates, please visit Easter egg maze on the back. Just cute little games for kids. Thank you. decent price for the amount of chocolate you're getting. I think it was something like $3. Okay. It's very cute. I love the big ears of the bunny. Tastes much better than a McCormick. It's rightly sweetened. It actually tastes a little stale, as though it's last year's chocolates. I would not be surprised. Very beautiful shape, and I love the quirkiness with the big ears. And on my chocolate blog, I also will have a little section where it will let you guys know whether I will repurchase this or not. So you have to get on over there to find out after this video is over. The entirety of each chocolate, the description, and my final thoughts. So this is a Belgian milk chocolate by the Euro Collection. And it is a turtle. Very inexpensive. I know it sounds expensive because of the Euro Collection, but this was only, I think, a couple of dollars. Now let's see. We said it's a cute little turtle. Great expression on his face. I love the little yellow embellishment. I guess it's part of his torso. And this is his shell. So he's almost too pretty. Sugar content is quite high. Actually, for half of the figurine, it's 22 grams. I don't approve, but the ingredient list is quite small, and the first ingredient on the list is chocolate, not sugar and fructose and sucrose and glucose. So, happy with that. Okay, moving on. And these are brands that I chose on purpose so we don't get bored with the conventional brands that I'm normally tasting. This is by Waterbridge, and it's really cute packaging. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 little duckies, and they all look little daisies and butterflies on the green pasture. This has limited like upon first impression of the actual chocolate. It's not only not artistic, but it's not actually well sculpted. This is a disappointment, unlike its packaging. Doesn't even taste like anything. Almost as though it's not even chocolate. I think there's minimum amount of milk, Oreo, and cream egg. So, where do we start? Let's do good looking egg. Fairly good size. They were about 99 cents each. It's very tasty. The caramel is of great consistency, but this is diabetic. If you really want, eat that on a daily basis, and it won't be long before a person gets cancer. Sorry about it. And the ingredient list. Yep. The first ingredient is glucose syrup and added sugar. Is mentioned much too many times in that egg. So this is the cream egg. Looks the same. Once again, I think this is even more toxic in sugar than the caramel. Oh. Thankfully, I have some green tea waiting for me in the kitchen to detoxify. And then I'm doing a cleanse. Then we have Oreo. Then I'm doing a cleanse by the company called Botanica. It's a brand new cleanse, I believe. It's in a liquid formulation, which I love liquids much more than capsules. It's called the restorative kit. So, this is the Oreo. Oh my, I'm sorry. That tastes like dental fillings. Oh. That tastes like chemicals. Pardon for my messy writing. I normally put my scripts on paper in a very neat manner, so that's unusual for me. Oh, that was dreadful. Oh. Next is the Oreo, the lamb. There we go. This is more like it. It's very cute. He has very big hair. Reminds me of my dad. Very nice and subtle. Well balanced. And it literally melts in your mouth, disintegrates very nicely. So, two more. It like a dark theme, and the paper itself is of fairly good quality. Shiny. I'm a little bit surprised that it is imperfect. I expected more from Ferrero, but can't have it all. Oh. Unexpected wafer. It is really superb. Wrapping, great. Chocolate, lazy or what's the word I'm looking for besides imperfect? Sloppy, that's what I'm looking for. That was a very nice surprise with the crunch. I definitely did not expect that. Last is the Godiva. And this best packaging. Yes. not flimsy. Really nice sheen to the chocolate. And the bunny. Logo even in the front, so you don't forget what you're eating while you're eating it. That's good marketing. Aggressive, but good marketing. Looks like a dark chocolate. Finally, perfectly balanced. Cacao, perfectly balanced. Sweetener, perfectly balanced. Cocoa butter. I guess I chose the prettiest, which ended up being the best tasting. Now, I must leave you guys with comments and thoughts on whether you have tried any of these chocolates. Let me know what you think. Once again, check out my blog for the final rating and review of each of these goodies. And I might use this for forming something. It's like the bunny, right? That was in here. I might use it to shape something with clay. Anyhow, that's it. I hope you're all going to have a wonderful Easter. Happy hunting for chocolates or whatever you're hiding, purses maybe, or some makeup, whatever your heart desires. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video.